Now, over the last 6 years of video making, I noticed a couple of things when it comes to all of you watching. You all love one thing in the Super Mario series. It's power-ups. Alongside the Koopalings, of course. What else? And so today, we will take a look at one type of power-up, the Mushrooms, who have actually been used for a whole lot of different things. They don't just give you more health. They can also completely change Mario and his abilities. So today, we will take a look at my favorite mushroom power-ups that were ever seen in the Super Mario franchise. So, let's jump right in. Number 5. Now, we all know that Nintendo can be very weird. There are enough things in the series that don't really make sense. But hey, that's because Nintendo mostly cares about gameplay. They want to make it fun, after all. And one great example of this is the Spring Mushroom. And personally, I love this power-up, even though it can be difficult to deal with. Now, it's seen in Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2, and looks like a metallic mushroom with eyes and a bulbous coil for a cap. Now, when you grab it, a spring wraps around you, allowing you to bounce around instead of walk. Thanks to this, you can't run anymore, you're a lot slower, and the character becomes very hard to control at times. Now, all of this sounds like a bad thing, right? Why would you ever want something like this in a Super Mario game? Well, there's a good reason for it. This thing allows you to jump a whole lot higher, and it also adds some challenge to it all. Aside from that, you also wall jump automatically, which can be very handy in certain situations. Now, in general, the levels that this item appears in are completely designed around this power-up, which is quite logical, actually. There are a lot of obstacles and things that you can only get past when you have this power-up. Otherwise, you just can't jump high enough. So in these levels, the challenge is controlling the character and timing your jumps well. That way, you can get extra height and go in the right direction. And while this sounds quite simple, it's a lot harder than you think. And to be honest, this challenge is what makes it fun. It limits you in so many ways, which makes everything harder. However, it also opens the doors to something new. You can reach places you were never even able to get close to. And as we all know, jumping is a big part of platforming games. And this power-up takes that whole concept to an extreme. And personally, I think it's appealing. Sure, it can also be frustrating, I know that. However, I never said it was flawless. I just think it's pretty neat. Number 4. Now, aside from jumping around, you can do a whole lot more in the Super Mario games. But you aren't completely free. There are some things that are just too powerful. One good example is the ability of flight. As you can imagine, this is incredibly handy in a 2D or even 3D platforming game. However, even though you would think that something like that is just too overpowered, Nintendo has given players the ability in a lot of their games. In both 2D and 3D titles, we see power-ups that allow you to fly, sometimes only for a limited amount of time. And there's one that was based around the mushroom that I absolutely love. The bee mushroom from the Super Mario Galaxy games. Now, when you collect it, you will turn into a bee, and you're then able to fly for a limited amount of time, can climb honeycomb walls, stand on flowers and clouds, and cling to the queen bee. But if you touch water, then the party is over, and you lose the power-up. Clearly, the concept is simple and completely designed for specific worlds, once again. Now that I think about it, that's a bit of a Super Mario Galaxy thing. But personally, I'm a big fan of the worlds it's seen in, and the actual power-up itself is also tons of fun. I like the design of the new Bee Mario and Luigi, and flying around is fun and quite laid back. Overall, navigating these levels is not that hard. The most challenging thing was probably the boss fight with the gigantic beetle. But that's fine. Sometimes in a Mario game, I want to mess around in a world that intrigues me with a power-up that's fun to use. And this one does exactly that. So to be honest, I'm not going to complain. And I've said in many other videos that I absolutely love it. However, I bet some of you are wondering, why is it not higher up on the list, Wily? Well, because if I'm honest with myself, it must end up here on the list. While I love it, I can see that it doesn't have a whole lot going for itself. I'm blinded to an extent by nostalgia. And so because of that, I didn't put it too high on the list. But I still have a lot of fond memories of it. Number 3. Now, there's a good reason why the bee mushroom didn't end up here, for example. And that's because our next power-up does something more interesting objectively. It also involves flight. However, it has a completely different approach, and therefore gives you different options. I'm talking about the propeller mushroom, which was introduced in New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Now, it was first seen in World 1-1, and it's one of the main power-ups of the game. And that was a good choice, in my opinion. Now, when you have it, it allows you to fly through the air, spinning straight up high into the sky, a bit like a helicopter. And then you gently float down to the ground. And this can be manipulated, because you can slow yourself down or speed up. For example, you can spin downward like a drill for an attack, with the same effects as a ground pound. Clearly, this power-up is already very different compared to something like the bee mushroom. And funny enough, if you leave the power-up alone, the propeller mushroom eventually flies out of the stage, which I quite like. It makes you panic a bit when you see one. Now, I will admit, your movement options with this power-up are very limited. You can go up quickly, move sideways slowly, and come down really fast with tremendous force. But even though you can't do everything you ever imagined, it's still a lot of fun to play with, because it does everything it can very well. Especially the going up or down with high speed is a lot of fun, because you can break through a barrier or crush enemies below you. So in both a combat and platforming situation, this power-up is incredibly handy. It allows you to get rid of obstacles and reach hard-to-get places. And you can easily get above an enemy or boss and crush him. That's what I like about it. You can do so much with it, and it certainly makes the 2D levels more interesting, because you can explore below the level and above. It makes it all more interesting, and allows Nintendo to do more with them, which you can certainly see in a lot of the levels that it's featured in. Number 2. Now, in this video, we've talked a lot about flight, and that's fun and all, but I want something more serious, more hardcore. A power-up that gives me an ability that makes me feel invincible, that gives me some real power. And the rock mushroom does a pretty good job of this, and more than just that. Now, when you pick it up, you get one new power. You can encase yourself in a boulder, and in this form, you can also accelerate, rolling around the level, destroying everything. And as you could have guessed, all of this involves a healthy amount of Wiimote shaking. I swear, sometimes I feel like a washing machine when playing those old Nintendo Wii games. But whatever. What matters now is that in this form you can roll around and jump, allowing you to damage enemies and destroy purple crystals with items inside of them. But hitting certain crystals or enemies will break the boulder you're in, so you are limited in certain ways. Aside from that, you can also use it for platforming by jumping off ramps. You can go quite fast as a boulder after all. Now, I love this power-up because it makes you feel very powerful. You can roll around and destroy, which is pretty great. But using it isn't a complete brain-dead experience. You gotta watch out because you can easily fall off a platform or piece of land. Aside from that, you also do some light platforming that's very fast-paced, which is a fun bonus. You boulder hop from planet to planet, and each time you get to the next part, you're once again busy with destruction. But there's one other that's even better. Number 1. Now we get to the top of the mountain, the best one out there, and I bet all of you already know which one this is gonna be. The Mega Mushroom. A power trip of an item that makes you feel like the Hulk or some monster from Pacific Rim. It turns you into a giant for a limited amount of time, and then you can walk around, being able to destroy everything in your path, and nothing can stop you at this point. And that's what I love about it. Now, I've talked about this power-up many times, so I won't talk about it for too long. And that's all because what I like about it is quite simple to understand. I love the raw power of it. It allows you to feel truly unstoppable. You're some sort of god, and are allowed to go on a rampage. Nintendo loves to add stuff like this to the games, because all of a sudden the player can go nuts. In a way, it's a power fantasy in a good way. way. The star power-up does a similar thing, and that's what makes it so fun, but only in short bursts. Most of us don't like games where everything is easy and enemies aren't a threat. That's quite boring after all. And Nintendo solved this by making it temporary and turning it into a short minigame of sorts for lives, where you can crush everything in sight. So yeah, this power-up is simple but offers something that almost all gamers just love. Extreme power. Normally, you only get to experience this at the end of a game, after getting all the best weapons, upgrades, and more. And usually that's fun, but on the other hand, a lot of enemies and challenges are boring. I had this a little teeny tiny bit on my second playthrough of Resident Evil 8. However, I never had this problem with the Mega Mushroom, thanks to its limited use design, which was certainly a great choice. And so because of all of that, I absolutely love it. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to leave a like. It really helps me with the algorithm, who is not kind to me. Leave your ideas down below for more videos or what you think of the list. And I will see all you lovely soon. Mwah!